what part of it they're seeing that is really the character, or me, you know, because I get in my mail a lot of it seems to think that a lot of me is in that character.
What the doctor ordered, Jim.
There's an old film that floats around every now and then that I wish they could all see, called Apache Uprising, in which I played a heavy. And at first we had this guy riding into town and a dog is barking at my horse and I shoot the dog. And that was cut. But I think if they had seen this guy, they would have been able to divorce me a little easier. Fuck! I admired McCoy very much, and I wish that I could be the kind of person that he is. But I'm not up to that yet. I'm gonna get there.
I never will understand the medical mind.
What's the matter, Jim?
The reality is the Earth is dying. We're killing it.
This atmosphere is remarkably similar to your 20th century. Moderately industrialized pollution, containing substantial amounts of carbon monoxide, and partially consumed hydrocarbons.
The word was smog.
And in a very short period of time, as short as our lifetimes, we're all going to die. Unless something extraordinary happens, like we stop the internal combustion engine. We're not going to do that. We humans will die. Life will go on.
Incredible that people can exist like this.
In those weird moments of anomaly, when we decide to clean something up, like the Thames or the river in New Jersey, suddenly the fish come back and life resumes. Not in 100 years. Not in 1,000 years, but in 1 year, 2, 3 years, the Great Lakes suddenly bloom again because we've cleaned it up.
Look at those pine trees
and that lake.
But we're not doing that. We are burning fuel at a faster rate. We're becoming more numerous at a faster rate.
The birth rate continued to rise and the population grew. Until now, Gideon is encased in a living mass who can find no rest, no peace, no joy.
We are burning the forest down at an increasing rate, and so we are blindly looking to shows like Star Trek to say there is a future, when in fact, if we don't answer the call, there's no future at all.
I know from good writing, I know from past writing, this was wonderful, wonderful writing. And you put great writing together with terrific acting. You know, it's, wow, is there anything better than that? No. I mean, take a look at all the brilliance that has been on television, with all the Dick Van Dyke shows and all the Honeymooners and the Phil Silver shows, and Star Trek is right up there. Brilliant writing, episode after episode after episode, and say what you want, you know, I mean, Shatner and Nimoy, and brilliant.
A terrible thing has happened. The boy was attending the fish nets, and he became entangled in them and sank to the bottom of the river.
I did another show some years later called Rescue 911. And Rescue 911 was successful because we concentrated on the people that were saved, not the people that died. And the people and the other shows that spun off from or imitated Rescue 911 and that failed made the dire mistake of telling the story of the people who died.
You'll be all right now.